For a long time, Chinese traditional classics have played a significant role in children's enlightenment. So learning the classics is an important part of an early education in China.
以前的时候有一些小朋友就是自信不够，当他们学完这些知识之后呢，小朋友的自信也慢慢的增加了。据我所知，因为咱们的家长特别认可咱们的中国传统文化，在外边也报了一些国学班之类的课程，然后来让孩子们更深刻的去理解这些中国的传统文化知识。
Meanwhile, primary and secondary education also focuses on the inheritance and promotion of fine traditional culture. Beijing revised Chinese textbook for compulsory education, adding reading materials from primers such as the three-character classic, 100 family surnames, and 1,000-character classic, in addition to classic poetry, mythology, fable, and historical stories in September 2016. Given the broad market of traditional education, major websites have produced innovative audiovisual programs to interpret and promote classics, which provides children with easy access to traditional literature.
在我给孩子进行传统文化的教育的时候，我有时候在想，孩子年龄那么小，他是不是能够真的理解？但是我发现，有的时候真的在生活当中，很无意间，他会给我很多的反馈，很多的惊喜。他有的时候在自己写作业的时候，就会突然跟我说，这个少壮不努力，老大徒伤悲。
Presenting the elegance and refinement of Chinese and ensuring cultural identity of Chinese people are the main targets among traditional culture education, which has a rich connotation. Traditional culture education also involves moral cultivation, especially for daily lives. Open curtains slowly without noise. Make turns widely without hitting the corners. The quote from Di Zhi Gui could perfectly apply to day-to-day life. Most importantly, modern education of traditional culture entails interest cultivation. For kindergarten kids, traditional games help them to learn to cooperate. Besides, primers and poetry of Tang and Song dynasties are suitable for primary school. As for middle and high school, the four books and five classics serve well for traditional education.